저희는 전 세계에서 왔습니다.
To N17. Because this is the place to be.
'Atrevámonos a crear nuestro propio camino.
To push the boundaries.
And dare to go one better.
So it was the shortest off-season ever, but we've got new kit, new signings, and a brand new season right on our doorstep. Welcome to N17 Live. So welcome to N17 Live and welcome back to our gorgeous home, Tottenham Hotspur Stadium. My name's Ben Haynes, and as ever on N17 Live, we're going to be here with you today right the way through until kickoff. We've got a very special game coming up for you today against Ipswich Town. It's our first pre-season match to get us in the mood for the Premier League campaign that starts on the 12th of September. And now it's just under half an hour to go until kickoff. It's a particularly special day, as I said, because it's our first opportunity to get a look at what Jose is going to do with the side tactically from a formation point of view, but also from a personnel point of view today. Lots to come on the show, but before we get into any of that, we're going to jump straight on into the team news, starting with the away team, Ipswich Town. Now, Ipswich are a bit of an interesting one because their season was curtailed in March, so they haven't actually played for a few months now. So just looking at their starting lineup, it looks as though they might play two very different sides in the first half and in the second half as well. A name that I'm looking out for there is Armando Dobra, very, very talented midfielder. Let's just take a little look at the subs bench now. And a name that you'll recognise on the bench that I think is really exciting is Andre Dezel. And the reason why, these are the subs for the first half. It looks like they'll be playing a different team in the second half. But a name that you'll recognise in the second half is Andre Dezel. His dad actually played here for nearly 100 games. Jason Dezel, phenomenal player for Spurs. So a warm welcome to Andre. Let's take a little look at that all-important Spurs lineup for this afternoon. Now, an interesting lineup here, and I'll let you guys at home try and work out the positions and the formation, but here's what I've got. It looks as though it's Toby Alderweireld and Juan Foyth in at centre-back, and then maybe Ben Davison at left-back with Sessegnon just in front. Perhaps we might see Jedson playing as a right wing-back, but a really interesting one here. We've got Pierre-Emile Højbjerg making his debut today. Harry Winks is in the midfield, and then Dele, Lucas and Son up top. Now, what I said before was about the wing-back roles, and I think they're going to be really crucial for Spurs today. At times during Project Restart, we saw Jose play with a 4-2-3-1. We saw him play with a 4-4-2 at times. Lucas perhaps maybe dropping in a little bit on the right-hand side. But really interesting over the first 20 minutes to see the formation that Jose has put out today. Let's just have a little look at the subs bench, because there's some really cool subs here today. Dennis Sirkin is one that I'm really, really interested in seeing. A lot of young players, actually. Cameron Carter-Vickers in there, Jack Clark, and also new signing Joe Hart on the bench as well. The players arrived just a short time ago, and they've had a pre-match meal, they've had a pre-match meeting, and it's really worth reminding ourselves of how special our form was towards the back end of the season. I think we did really, really well at home, unbeaten, and some phenomenal results in there against Leicester and also against Arsenal. I'm sure you all remember that first Premier League North London derby here at Tottenham Hotspur Stadium. And it's going to be a busy 7 days or so for Spurs, actually. We've got a couple of really, really cool fixtures coming up for you. First, Ipswich Town, of course, today. But then we've got two more pre-season matches that are coming up as well. So let's just take a little look at the fixtures that we've got coming up in a week's time. So Ipswich today, and then we've got Reading and we've got Birmingham City coming up as well. So lots for Jose to trial and lots of time for players to get some game time there across the entirety of the squad. So those are the fixtures, and I just want to do a little bit of housekeeping for you to make it nice and straightforward for you. So now a lot of you will be watching N17 Live on social, but if you want to watch the game today, you need to go to live.tottenhamhotspur.com, where you can purchase a game for £10. Or if you want to watch all three of the friendlies, then you can pay £20 and you'll get all three. It's still time to do that now. So if you jump on over there now, you can do that. I just need to make it clear to you that in some territories, it might be on television. So just have a little look before you pay to make sure that that your area is showing the game on Spurs TV. So it's live.tottenhamhotspur.com, and it's £10 for today and £20 for all three of those pre-season matches. Before we get into the thick of today's game, really, really exciting one for you, a new feature that's going to be a part of match day here. It's our 2020-2021 new kit.
To N17.
Because this is the place to be.
Atrevámonos a crear nuestro propio camino.
Dare to push the boundaries.
And dare to go one better.
Time to introduce today's special guest. I'm very, very excited to have him back. An N17 Live favourite of ours and a club legend. Welcome back, Clive Allen. It's
good
great
afternoon.
To have you here.
Yeah, it's great to be here. Great to be back in the stadium, albeit without the supporters. That's the only one thing missing, but you can sense there's a real atmosphere to the start of a new season.
Clive, you wouldn't have seen, but I was watching as you came round the corner, and it was so refreshing and so nice because you just lit up as soon as you saw the pitch as ever. It's still special, isn't
Absolutely.
It?
Absolutely. Always puts a smile on my face, always get that tingle down my spine, I have to say. Obviously, I played my time in White Hart Lane, just 100 yards down there, but this place is something magical about it. And the old White Hart Lane has certainly been moved into the new Tottenham Hotspur Stadium.
Just tell us what you're going to be looking out for today. Can you tell us a little bit about the idea of playing in these pre-season matches? What can you learn from a game like this?
It's always really important. The coaches will be emphasising that to the players. It's the start of a new season. And for the players, they always, for all the work that you put in pre-season training, there's nothing like a competitive game against opposition, whoever that opposition might be. And Ipswich will be a stiff test for us today. And I think it's really important. Jose will be really focused on his team, his players, individuals, and the attitudes of the players is so important. That's what the coaches will be looking at. It's the start of a new season.
Let's pick up on a couple of those players that you that I'm sure you want to talk about. Pierre-Emile Højbjerg, who is an incredibly exciting signing. What is he going to bring to this Tottenham side?
I think it's a really interesting signing because I think it's a really disciplined role that he's played. He's played it at Southampton. I think Jose's seen that as something that he wants to see in his team, that defensive midfield, really disciplined in the way that he plays the game. He's competitive, he passes the ball well, and I think that's something that's going to be really important. And I think he's a valuable addition to the squad, I really do.
Absolutely, and you can see some of his highlights against us from last year. Some brilliant saves from Hugo in there as well. But I think the thing that you pointed out rightly there is that he provides that shield, doesn't he? He provides that cover for the defence, but also a platform for our attackers to go on and play.
Absolutely, I think, and it's that central role. I think the way that he plays, he has to be disciplined. Mentally, he has to be really tough not to get dragged out of position, not to move into areas where we could be exposed centrally in defence. He's that first line of defence in front of the two centre-halves or three if we play that way. So I think that it's a really detailed, it's a really specialist role that he will bring to the team.
Yeah, and it's quite a rare skill now, isn't it, to find a really specialised central defensive-minded midfielder, and you think that perhaps might change a little bit of Eric Dier's role as well, don't you?
I do. I think that obviously at the end of last season we had a fantastic run of results. Eric was playing at centre-half. I think there's a clear indication that Jose sees Eric as a central defender rather than playing in that role, which he has done, and he has done well. But I think that now you will see Eric become one of a number of centre-halves for the club.
I wanted to ask you about another one of our new signings, Joe Hart. Now, lots of people having various opinions on the signing, but on a personal level, I think it's fantastic that we're bringing in a proven winner and someone who's going to be a really big personality in this side.
Absolutely, Ben, I totally agree with you. I think that is one of the reasons why Joe will be a magnificent influence on a lot of players, not only the young players, because they will look up to him. They know what he's done in his career to date. I think that Joe's experience is going to be invaluable. When he's called upon, you know, over the years, he's been a model professional, consistent performer. So I can fully understand why he's been added to the squad. Why the goalkeepers will benefit. Even Hugo, I think, will bounce off of him. And I think that there'll be healthy competition in that department as well, which is important for a team moving forward and being successful.
There's no real downside in bringing a Premier League winner into the team, is there?
Absolutely
not. It's just a benefit for everyone.
Absolutely, and I think that's something that Jose knows of. He's done that before. I think when you look at the history of signings that he's made, people think, well, perhaps not past their best, but what are they going to offer the team? And Joe Hart is going to offer the team and the club a lot.
And a really good opportunity, I think, for Joe Hart as well, to try and reignite his career to some extent. Had some difficult times over the last couple of years, but I do like the confidence that he's come in with, that he's not here to make up the numbers. He's coming to push for a place in this side, isn't he?
Well, I think, as you say, Ben, he's been a winner. He's won the Premier League. He's been an international goalkeeper. He's played at the highest level. So you know that he has outstanding ability. And when you have ability like that as a player, you want the opportunity to be able to show that. You want to recapture that if you've dropped off of the levels that you've set over your career. Joe Hart, I am sure it will be working tirelessly to become number one. That will be his aim. He'll be pushing Hugo and Paolo Gazzaniga as well. It's fierce competition for the goalkeeping spot.
Clive, just quickly, I want to pick your brains on what you think about the formation today. It's quite difficult to pick apart, but just tell us what you think is going to play out.
Well, I think one of the things is we can change. We can play with a flat back four, but I think we'll more than likely play with the three central defenders and the wing back, Sessegnon on the left, and Ben Davies as a left-sided central defender, which he's played before. And on the right, you could see Jenson Fernandez playing on the right-hand side as a wing-back. So, but again, there's a number of options. I'm really interested to see how we start off, but I'm sure we could easily change as well in and out of possession of the ball.
I completely agree. And as Clive mentioned a little bit earlier on, it's a real shame that we can't have you back here, but things are slowly opening back up. In fact, we've got something very, very exciting about to come your way as well. Here is a little look at our new Skywalk. We'll be right back. It looks amazing, doesn't it? And I've just had my producer tell me in my ear that I'll be doing that next week. So a good time to be afraid of heights. Let's rock on in to some messages from the club. We've got a special offer on at the moment. Two Nike shirts for £25. So you can get involved on that, tottenhamhotspur.com. But the club shop is open up as well. So make sure you check that out. As well as that, we've got 20% off all headwear. So give that a little look as well on tottenhamhotspur.com. Stadium tours are back in full swing. Don't miss your chance to come behind the scenes of what is undeniably the best stadium in the world. And our global football development programme is back and has been carefully planned to be delivered safely at the highest quality by our FA and UEFA qualified coaches. Go to tottenhamhotspur.com/development to see more there. Remember, if you haven't already, to download the Spurs app. There's going to be loads of content coming your way at full time. And then as well as that, if you haven't already followed us on social, what are you doing? Get onto it at Spurs Official on Twitter and on Instagram. And if you can use for me the hashtag Coys, that's really, really helpful because it means we can get in touch with you throughout the day. Let's just take a little look at Ipswich. Players are out behind us warming up. Clive, you mentioned before that Ipswich are a club that are steeped in history, aren't they? They're a very exciting club to look at in terms of a historical perspective.
Absolutely. I think they've always had a tradition of developing their own young talent. They've had some fantastic teams, none more so in the era that I played, Bobby Robson, the former England manager in charge. Wonderful teams, very successful. What I call a proper football club. Over the years, historically, they've been very strong. Obviously, it's quite away from London, but they've always attracted top players. So it's a breeding ground for a lot of young talent to develop. And I think we'll see one or two maybe starlets of the future playing for Ipswich today.
Clive, can we talk about your ITK that you gave us about Bobby speaking to you potentially about the option of maybe looking at Ipswich as a potential club?
Yes, as a 15-year-old, it's a really interesting story. I played at White Hart Lane for London Schools on the Monday night. Tuesday I was at Ipswich as a schoolboy training, and Wednesday as a 15-year-old trained with the Ipswich first team. And then Bobby Robson, in his own style, tried to get me to sign schoolboy forms and become an Ipswich Town youth team player. It was between Spurs, Ipswich, and obviously I started my career at Queen's Park Rangers. But Ipswich was a fantastic club many years ago.
Amazing stuff. Ipswich will be playing with two 11s today, so it looks as though they'll play 1-11 in the first half and then mix things up in the second. How does that affect Spurs, and is that a good idea in a game like this, just to try and get everyone some game time?
Well, I think it's always a test, and it'll be a test for the Spurs team, having to adapt to obviously playing against opposition they're not accustomed to, different types of systems. Paul Lambert, the manager, is vastly experienced, great player in his day, has done a great job in really steadying the ship at Ipswich when he came in last season. And he's fiercely competitive. He'll be looking at his young team, and he is a predominantly young side, really trying to make a mark today. It's important in their preparation for their League One campaign, and it will be a good test for us.
And in terms of the squad that they put out today, the first half, like you said, there's a lot of young players in the first half, but there's some talent on the coming on from the second half, particularly Jason Dazelle's son, Andre Dazelle. You didn't play with Jason Dazelle, did you? But a bit of a legend here at Spurs.
Absolutely, yeah, over 100 games, as you said earlier. I think he was a really good attacking midfield player. One of those players that arrived in the box, late runs, scored important goals as well. And he really played well at this club. His son obviously has broke into the Ipswich side very young. There was great expectations of him. Obviously he was following in his father's footsteps, so that was always going to be difficult for him. I would say his career's just levelled out a bit, but an opportunity for him. He'll really be excited about the chance to play here at his dad's old club.
It's got a little bit quiet behind us, hasn't it, now? Because the Spurs boys have gone inside and have just finished their warm-ups. What are you looking to see from Spurs today, Clive? I can tell you on a personal level, I'm super excited to see Højbjerg, but from a wider perspective of what you're looking to get from the game.
I think it's always about the attitude of the players, especially at this early stage of the season. Do they get their work done in the right way? Certainly as a coach, you're looking at them. Is their attitude good? Do they really get the miles under their belt? Game time is so vitally important. I thought it was fantastic the way we finished the season, so strong. The break hasn't been a long one. I'm sure they've kept themselves in really good shape. So I would expect us to pick up very, very quickly. High tempo, really start the season and start this first game in the way that we intend to go on into that first game against Everton in the coming weeks.
Clive, you've done my job perfectly for me, because it's time now to take a little look at our Premier League fixtures, because they've been announced just this week. So let's take a little look at what's coming up for us.
Lo Celso on the turn, and it's ended up in the back of the net. Son. His teammates scream out in support, but Son doesn't need any support. The flag has stayed down for Harry Kane to make it 2-0. Some magic from Dele Alli has put Spurs ahead for the first time today. Lucas Moura clips it. Oh, great goal! Stephen Bergwijn has arrived in North London. Son is free to score. 2-0 Tottenham Hotspur. And Son has nicked in for what will be the equaliser. Brilliant work from Heung-min Son. Oh, and the head is into the net. And Toby Alderweireld is the man celebrating. Lucas waiting, Lo Celso waiting, but Kane will score something truly special. Pass again, Trippier, Eriksen, and Lucas Moura has scored. And the deflection takes it against the bar, and Kane is there to pounce. And Son is still going. It is a magic moment from Heung-min Son.
Here's Harry Kane for three. Oh, how about that for a finish?
Return it to Sissoko. And Sissoko scores first bit.
Let's have a good delivery on him. And that is excellent. Oh, what a goal that is. On the volley for Son. Difficult angle for Son. It's on Bailey. Still going, scores. Bergwijn all the way. What a brilliant goal. Oh, it runs to Son. It's a mistake by Sheffield United. And the goal has been gifted to Spurs. Taken by Son. Dele Alli to the back post. And he flicks it goalwards. And it's smashed into the net from close range by Stephen Bergwijn. Lucas Moura. And belted into the net.
It's always a special day, isn't it, when the fixture list comes out and you can't help it. Your eyes are immediately drawn, Clive, to a few big games, aren't they? When you were a player, who was the game you were looking at from a Spurs perspective?
Always the Arsenal game. When is that going to be? Historically, it was always over the festive period, New Year's Day or Boxing Day. London derbies, always difficult games, so you're just looking as to where they come in the schedule. But I think... you're always looking at a start where you're hoping or looking at games where you feel positive about getting results and getting off to a good start. And I think our fixtures at the start are positive for us. We could really get off to a good start, which would be fantastic.
It's nice, isn't it, hearing the pre-match music kicking.
Here we go.
It's very, very special. You get that feeling, don't you? And we're starting off against Everton. So you and I were here a few weeks ago watching Spurs v Everton. Not the most entertaining game, but got the win. And hopefully we'll get off to a good start. Good start at home, isn't it?
Yeah. Yeah, and I think the way we play in that game could influence the way we play against them at the start of the season, because it was a good performance, it was a great result, much needed in the start of what was a good run. So I think that it's a favourable start. To be at home on the opening day, I always think is very, very good.
100%. Clive, thank you so much for being with us pre-match. Clive's going to be back with us at half-time and at full-time as well. I'll let you go down and get into position. I will see you very, very shortly, Clive. Okay, so as you can hear, the music playing behind me means it's all getting ramped up here and ready to go. The players will be out very, very shortly. I just want to remind you very quickly of a couple of things. Firstly, at Spurs Official on Twitter and on Instagram, if you haven't already, to make sure that you're across all of the socials. And then just a little bit of housekeeping to finish up. It's not too late. If you do want to watch the game, make sure you get over to live.tottenhamhotspur.com. and you can pay £10 to watch a game today, or you can still pay £20 and you can get all three of those pre-season fixtures. And just make sure that it's available in your territory as well. Just a little reminder that if you do get onto the game, we'll be here for you on Spurs TV, live to TottenhamHotspur.com at half time and at full time as well. So we'll be reacting to all of the big talking points across the first half as well as across the second half. Clive Allen will be back with me and we'll be having a right good natter through all of the massive talking points. Hopefully a very, very exciting game coming up. Just a little reminder as well, this new kit is available, TottenhamHotspur.com. Make sure you get on over there. You can get your hands on that. Really great away kit as well. Just remains for me to say thank you so much for watching the show. Thank you for being along with us. Hope you've enjoyed it. Fingers crossed, it's a massively exciting game full of goals. Come on, you Spurs. Let's do this one.